Most of the time, sleight of hand is done for a nefarious purpose, which I'm about to demonstrate.
Yes.
I grew up in a little town in Tennessee, Clarksville, Tennessee. I was a preacher's kid. And when I was about 9 years old, this old man moved into our neighborhood. He was in his 80s. He had been a professional gambler his whole life and was a total reprobate. He drank whiskey right straight out of the bottle, chain smoked these little black cigars and cussed like a sailor. So naturally, as a preacher's kid, I gravitated toward his society. And this is one of the things he taught me that stood me in good stead over the years, called the shell game. He uses three little half walnut shells and a little pea. Now these are not real half walnut shells. When I started out, they were. I ate the walnuts. I carved the shells out. I practiced with them till my fingers were bleeding, and I got really good at it. These are not real walnuts. These are
silver solid.
I've been very lucky at this game. Over the years, I was able to get my nuts cast in silver. Because they ring better. But that's not the point. The point is that the game is still the same. All you have to do is keep up with the little P. If you know where the P is, you bet against me. This lady right here, you look like you have a pair of eyes on you.
What's your name? Tiffany.
Tiffany, you want to play a little game?
Sure.
Oh, good. Where's the Pete?
The left.
Yeah, no.
I was going to see the center first.
Oh, you should have said that first. Yeah. Let's try it again. Where's B?
The left.
What?
The left one.
This one?
Oh, my word.
What was your name again? Is
Tiffany.
Tiffany, where's the P?
The center.
Oh, Tiffany, you have eyes like a red. I may have to move the shells around to be you. You still want to play though, right? Because I get a lot of complaints, especially from the ladies, that say you started too fast or I wasn't ready. I don't want to hear any crap like that out of you. You know where the pee is, Tiffany. You know where it is not. Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, the speed, the blinding speed. I'm lost myself, Tiffany. They always let you win the first time. Where is it?
Okay, the one that's...
This one?
Yeah.
That's a loser.
Oh, yeah.
No, remember, the first time you said it was in the middle, that wins.
Yeah.
This is the second time everybody loses the second time.
Okay, let's go for
and that
the...
doesn't count the five or six freebies I gave.
Sure,
and I'll give you a third chance. They don't even do that on the street. I would go here if I was you.
Okay, let's do that one.
What?
Let's do your recommendation.
This one?
Yeah, sure.
See, you should listen to me, Tiffany. I actually know where the P is. So look, you've learned something.
Yeah, I did.
You've learned what? You've learned that Pop knows where the P is. And you've learned that you can trust Pop. And let's play again, see what else we might learn. You ready?
Yeah.
You know where the P is?
Mm-hmm.
You know where it's not? Here we go. Oh, the speed, the blinding speed. I've lost myself. Whoop!
Oh.
Okay. Mm-hmm. In the middle?
No, that's a loser. I would have gone there.
Yeah? Okay, let's go there.
Uh-uh. Okay, see, now you learn something new. You learn something new. It's not that you can't trust me, but you have to know when.
Yeah.
This strategy works with most men. Let me explain to you why people lose at this game. The reason is the pee does not stay under the shell it starts from. If you watch between the shells, you'll actually see that pee move from one shell to another. Could you see that?
Yeah.
So obvious. So obvious. It's like it's got little legs. like a clam. But that's because that's at half speed. At full speed, you can't see anything. I'll do it once at half speed, once at full speed. Nice. That way you have something to compare.
Nice.
Ready?
Yes.
Yes.
You saw that thing.
Wow.
Wow. Wow. That's the one at full speed. That's the one at full speed. Now, folks, I'll tell you a little bit about the history of this game. We don't know who invented it. Could have been a man, could have been a woman. We really don't know. The origins have been lost in the mires of time. So I can say just about anything that I want. This game was invented by a man. And his name was Throg. He was a Neanderthal fella, playing with half a coconut shell and a little white smooth river pebble he found on the beach. That was his favorite toy. By accident one day, as he was fooling around, the way those Neanderthals were wont to do, he accidentally covered the pebble with the shell. And when he turned back around, it was as if the pebble just disappeared into thin air. He looked all over and he couldn't find it. By accident, he lifted up the shell and there it was. Well, it wouldn't be a big deal for me either, but to a Neanderthal, this is a 2001 moment. This kept him occupied all afternoon. He took it back to the campfire, showed it to the other Neanderthals. It became the most popular game of the entire Neanderthal period, called the One Shell Game. Now, as man's cranial capacity grew, the game lost a bit of its cachet. Till some genius Cro-Magnon man came up with the idea of adding two more shells, creating what we would call a three-shell game. Although they didn't play it the way we do today, they would just move these two around to confuse things. This is before logic had been invented by the Greeks. Before logic was invented, they always bet on one of those two. Because why? Because they were the ones that were moving. Before logic was invented, that would have made some kind of sense. Yes. Wouldn't mean anything to a modern crowd such as yourself. Now, folks, let's make this as simple as we possibly can. Would you help me? Place the shell on top of the pea. Place the glass on top of the shell. Hold your finger out like this. That's your thumb. Finger. You get to pick one of these here. Put your finger out like that. Well, okay. Now this one or that one. That was the one you picked. I'll take this one if you want. Right. Now look at this. You know where the pea is, you have control of it, you have control of two of the shells. This is what they call on the street a lead pipe cinch. On the street, people rip their pockets, taking every dime they've got. They lay it on a table, they say stupid things like, "Pop, I've got you now." But you wouldn't do that, would you? Because you're an intelligent lady. And you know the instant a dime hits this table, what's going to happen.
Oh.
Check. It's like a little miracle, I think.
That's the show, Dan Meyer, Pop 80. We got to have a nice evening.